and welcome to another electrifying episode of Arts Jamboree, the Jamaica Cultural Development Commission's showcase of the arts, as we develop, preserve, and promote the creative talents of Jamaicans. I'm Dion Silvera, and let me tell you no something. Clear out little space in the living room from now, because you're going to want to get up and move your body to this one, yes. Today we'll be taking a look at the JCDC's dance competition, which provides a stage for rich expressions in several genres, including creative folk, modern contemporary, praise, popular, jazz and dance drama. Let's get grooving with a few words from the specialist. Soon come back.
JCDC as an organization would have started in 1964. It was centered around the time when the country was trying to locate its identity in the context of independence. And what better way to do it than through the arts? So the JCDC provided that platform where community members could showcase who we are as a people from their ethnic understanding. Present day, the journey continues because you will have practitioners who were teachers, who were participants. They are now engendering that same independent spirit in current performers and current choreographers. So what you're going to see in this presentation, you will see a generation who is currently practicing. You will see a generation who would have made a platform for themselves by shaping, forming a company who is still producing or showcasing brand Jamaica in their choreographic outlook.
I'm a JCDC dance baby, and so it grew in me. I actually started in high school with Vincent Douglas being my first tutor. Further on, I started my hand at dance making with him. When I left high school, I started to work with the Tivoli Dance Group and also went to Edna Manley at that time. And so, you know, I got a full mix of what was out there for me to learn. Then from there, the Tivoli Dance Troupe was birthed from the high school because we had dancers who had little sisters and brothers who would come and sit. And so the Tivoli Dance Troupe, being the longest standing entrance in the JCDC dance competition, grew to be a school and community dance group. Because at one point we had a 90% of the members of the dance troupe not living in the community, not attending Tivoli High School, but just because of I think everybody wants to be a part of a good thing. And so it grew from there. And so we have accomplished a lot through those years. We have over 3,000 medals and awards. We were the first recipient of the Rex Nettleford Trophy for Excellence in Dance. We have in the competition now 14 of our past members as teachers.
As a dancer before, I know I'm a choreographer. The lesson that I've learned before as a choreographer, as a dancer, is from the Tivoli Dance Troupe. There's 3D my dance teacher teaches me: discipline, dedication, and determination. With those 3Ds I've put across all throughout my life, and I put it towards my students. Before I prepare for the JCDC competition first, I have to see the type of students I'm getting in. That's one. Two, I have to look back on my competitors And three, I have to think about my costume, because costume is very important to your dance. With the JCDC for me, with the student, it has given them a wide range of, not just in their community, stay in their community, they go, get to go to different parishes, they get to go and see, to see different students, get to see different culture. I'm based in St. Catherine, and every parish has their own culture. So like, for instance, St. Thomas and the Western region, wider region, they are different, more of the creative folk A, where I'm mostly associated with creative folk B. So my students get to learn from those schools in the different parishes to bring back to their schools, because remember, we also have Jamaica Day in our school. And in my school, for instance, loves creative folk B, as I said before. So when I have to put the creative folk A on them for cultural day, they also learned from other parishes or other schools in the JCDC. So if it wasn't for JCDC, with the wide range of dance and get to exhibit different culture, different folk form and modern contemporary and all the genre, my student owner, I've learned so much, not from me, but they have learned for the entire time they have been during the process of the competition.
Well, I entered from about 2002. I remember my fascination with dance started just by a glimpse. I think I was meant to see the dance at the time. I was just passing the auditorium, seeing dancers just performing. And as a young man, I've never really known much about dance. And then when I saw them, I was so enthused. I was so caught up with it that I just, from that, I was, my love for it just continued growing. The JCDC has brought so many good things for me in terms of dance, because it has a way to bring out the best in you. There are benefits out of it if you keep on pushing. And then if it's something that you love and you're really entering the JCDC competition, you should push yourself. Don't, even if you get, you know, some people really like the gold and all, but even if you get a silver, which I've learned so many times, I've gotten so many silver, but it is just a love for it that you have, that you keep on going. So no matter what you get, bronze and merit, you keep pushing. Once is it as something that you love, you keep going forward to it, going ahead, keep working hard.
Any artistic expression, whether it is music, dance, or drama, would be centered around the lived experience. So just as though the music is documenting the history, the dancer is also documenting that history, because there is a correlation.
This is my motive statement for my dance, Movac.
This is my motif statement for my dance, Frequency.
Because of the approach of our teachers, they would have choreographed their dances for the competition in front of the dancers. Now the dancers themselves, they are learning how to choreograph. They are learning to be disciplined. So oftentimes you would notice that we have returning competitors, and they are returning in the form of a teacher. They used to dance and now they are choreographing. So that is one of the legacy, this on the spot, indirect way of learning how to choreograph.
The competition for us started in about 1984-85 at the Stella Maris Prep School. I must tell you that at first, we didn't get a goal. You know, we got like merit and, you know, that sort of thing, but it didn't discourage us. And after a while, we consistently entered from about 85, right up until about 1994. We consistently entered. And it afforded the students, because they were coming from prep school, they went through that process of entering, and then when they entered high school, they still continued. And it was not maybe until maybe there were about sixth formers so that we started the Stellamaris Dance Ensemble, where I think we only entered twice after that. The students learned at an early age performing, how to perform. And they were exposed through the JCDC to a lot of other groups. So in seeing the other groups, that also assisted them in learning better. As artist director, when we were looking for male dancers, we would then go to JCDC to source our dancers. And we brought in maybe about 8 or 9 of them, like Alvin Small, who is still with us now as one of our teachers at the prep school. We have Michelle Bailey, Patrick, Michael, Dwayne, who later formed his own dance company. We also, at Excelsior, we also went to Excelsior, and there we had Orville Hall, who is now with Dance, who is now the Artistic Director of Dance Expression, and Shelly-Ann McCallum, and they were all at Stella, you know. And as you see, one of our classic works, Liza, was choreographed with Orville Hall as the boyfriend in that piece, yes.
I know from Rex Nettleford, I did History of Dance with him, and I know what it means to him. I can tell you our first concert, Tivoli first concert in 1979 was at the Ward Theater, and we invited him. Now this venture was just my idea with the girls, and so he came. And I must tell you, I appreciated him for the fact that it never meant who invited him. It's that he saw the process. He knew what dance meant for this group. And so, look for a letter in the morning. He's going to tell you. I have the letter even to today. It's a part of my treasure. And he said, it's not the beginning. It's a continuity. You can do it. And so I always tell them that this is a part of our mantra to continue the process.
Well, my experience coming out of festival taught me a great deal. You had to learn discipline, self-discipline, and the discipline of your craft. You had to learn teamwork and commitment, devotion. All of those things were very important. Hard work. There were times when I remember we would have to come outside of the classroom and we would have to be downstairs practicing while everybody's, you know, studying or doing classwork. And we had to be able to balance our lives. I think that was one of the very important things that it taught us as youngsters, and certainly I have taken that into my adult life, that there needs to be balance. And when there is passion, it makes the labor even sweeter, you know. But certainly when you have commitment to something, when you have a discipline, stick-to-itiveness to see things through to the end, those are values, those are principles that will inure to your benefit in the long run, years, even after that.
JCDC festivals are part of the reason why I'm a performer today. because I was with the Wilma's Prep School and we used to go to the JCDC dance festivals. And when I went, what I really learned from being a part of those festivals, apart from the community and that feel and sense of love in the dance community, was performance skills. That's where I honed my performance skills. As a dancer, you just go out on the stage and you dance your heart out and you enjoy yourself in the meanwhile too, but it's all about that performance skill, that ability to perform for an audience. Jamaica is where I started, and Jamaica is always where my heart will reside, and most importantly, where my dancing heart resides. So I just want to always give thanks to the island and to the dance community.
I can't live without you. So here's my heart, but here's my mind. I give you my soul, Lord. Need you to take control.
Beneath this skin, as a people, we move forward to reclaim our thrones. Beneath, woman rises to greatness, to strength, to equal. Beneath this skin breathes new life.
My journey as an adjudicator really opened my knowledge so much. It took me from Kingston, getting up early in the morning, as far as losing an over, driving by myself. But you are not afraid because you're focused to go and do something. You see these children coming in from their schools and they're coming on stage, and once they hit the stage, they are giving their best. The way the adjudication set up by the JCDC, it gives a fairness. It doesn't matter which parish you're from. The children in Lucy and over, in St. Mary, in Portland, right across the island, the same standard of judging is there. So as adjudicators, we also have to open our mind and know what we're looking for. We have seen where groups that have not been exposed, they go through the zone, they go to the parish, and they come to national finals and end up getting national golds. The workshops that are put on by the JCDC have also helped and encouraged a lot of teachers, especially those in the parishes outside of Kingston and St. Andrew.
Wait a minute. I know that we haven't seen the stage in a while, but I did enjoy that moment.
I loved
yeah,
it.
It was good.
There's nothing like a good developer to warm the soul, you
good
know?
Good point, good point, good point. No, let's stick to the point. Now, yeah. You are a dancer, a professional dancer, mm-hmm. but you started in the JCDC dance competition.
I did indeed.
Did you remember the year? Do you remember the year?
Yes, I did. I think it was, I did 1992, 1993, and I think maybe 94 as well. I danced with Queens High School under the tutelage of Adrian Fletcher.
Also with Tivoli Dance.
Yes.
Tivoli dance troupe. Yeah. Oh, very good. So there is a thread of practitioners in the JCDC
Definitely.
Competition. But as a young dancer, moving on the international scene, how does the JCDC dance experience prepared you for that international scene?
Well, interestingly enough, because I've been listening to various people talk about their experience and what JCDC have done for them, but something that it did for me, it definitely etched a certain competitiveness. You know what I mean? There's a drive because everybody's performing and it is a competition as well as everything else that it is, but it also is a competition. So part of the thing that it placed in me was a desire to win. You know what I mean? Everybody everybody wants to get a medal, but imagine if you get gold.
Okay,
you know what I mean? So
yes.
Everything, just the experience is wonderful, but you know, we're all really there to be the best of the best, the best of the best of the best. So for me, when I was in England training, that JCDC experience of really looking what's around you. You know, you see all the other schools competing and everything, and you're like, okay, I need to be better than, I need to outperform. And that served me. When I was here in Jamaica, I didn't know where this could take me.
Okay.
I didn't know that I could end up being in Lion King or end up having a career purely in dance. Because I feel like even here in Jamaica, we don't fully appreciate that dance is a viable career path all by itself. It doesn't need to be something that you do on the side or part-time. Like,
right.
There's viability in it. And until persons embrace it as such, it's always gonna be on the sideline. It's gonna be a hobby or something you do after your job. And I just don't believe that. So that's why I love what JCDC is doing. I love that they're training, teaching persons about intellectual property, how to treat dance as a business, discipline of dance, you know, so that they can grow into that and understand just the importance of it.
Good.
Some water while you don't put back the furniture. We have to officially lock off the dance for now. But you can't go and bounce. Go and bounce a bit. Go and bounce till next time. This has been Arts Jamboree, the JCDC's showcase of the arts. Remember to join the conversation online via social media, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and like us on Facebook and Instagram. Until next time, I'm Dion Silvera. Walk good.